Hello, today I want to show you a new type of melon and pumpkin farms. Before I explain how it works and how to build it, first let's see it in action. I increase the tick speed by 100 to see it working. As you can see, the farm is bud powered, it detects the growth of pumpkins and instantly harvests them. Okay, back to normal speed. So how does this work? The basis for the farm is the very simple slime block and redstone bud detector. It detects block updates next to the piston. Laggard from the Skycraft server came up with the idea to use this to harvest pumpkins. As you can see, if I place a pumpkin in there, the dirt is pushed up and the pumpkin gets broken. As you can see, in this configuration, the pumpkin gets thrown out to the sides and this farm wouldn't be useful. He came up with the idea to use immovable leaf blocks next to the slime blocks. Which causes the pumpkins to land on top of the construction. So all that is left to do is to add a water stream to it to channel the items to be collected in an hopper and get transported to the chest here. Now let's build it. To build it, you need the following things: fences, dirt, sticky pistons, slime blocks, redstone blocks, a light source, either glowstone or sea lanterns, then pumpkins or melons, either carpet or string, whatever is cheapest for you, water, a hoe, and leaf blocks. First, we start building one of those dirt circles. Next, we add a light source on the button and add a sticky piston on it and add the slime blocks. Because of the 12 block piston push limit, we could also add another slime block line on the other side to make it more space efficient. As you can see, if I place a redstone block on it, we have 9 slime blocks. One redstone block and 2 dirt blocks, so in total 12 blocks that gets pushed. Okay, let's do it on the other side. Next, we want to add a water source. We do it between the slime blocks to make sure there's absolutely no spillage of water. You can also place leaf blocks here. Next, we till the dirt to be farmland. And place a carpet in these middle sections. I will later explain what's the use of the carpet and the farmland. So then let's place our pumpkin seeds. And add the leaf blocks. And the fences. And finally, the water. It's very important that on the outside are pumpkin stems, so that the water source blocks that gets destroyed by the slime blocks are regenerated from the outside and inside water sources. Okay, let's speed up the tick rate to see it in action. So, as you can see, the farm already starts producing. All you have to do next is to add either hoppers down below or a water stream to collect the pumpkins. They all land on the block beneath the fences. So why the extra farmland? Every tick, the game selects 3 out of 4096 blocks for a random tick update. So on average, every block gets selected every 8.2 seconds. If one of these tick updates selects a pumpkin stem, it either selects one of the 4 directions. As you can see in our setups, the middle stem has 2 sides to grow and the outer stems just have 1 side to grow. So for the middle stems, the chance is reduced by 50% and for the outer stems by 75%. What's next is the growth probability algorithm. It's 1 divided by floor, 25 divided by points plus 1. Floor is just it rounds down to the next integer. Points are for hydrated farmland 4 and for the surrounding hydrated farmland 0.75. So the more points you have, the higher the probability for a pumpkin to grow. As you can see, we have 1 hydrated farmland under the pumpkin stem, which gives 4 points, and here's the extra farmland with 0.75 points. We either place a carpet or a string on top of it, which doesn't destroy the farmland but also prevents the pumpkins to grow there. So, as a conclusion, without extra farmland, if you use the algorithm, on average every about 16 minutes a pumpkin grows, and with the extra farmland in between, it's just 13.65 minutes. This results in 16.7% higher rates. Due to the glitchiness of the slime block transportation, some of the pumpkins are either thrown out the side or land in the middle. From my estimates, about 2 to 3% of the pumpkins get lost in normal tick speed. So as an estimate, for every middle section of pumpkin stems, you could gain about 4 pumpkins per hour, and for the outer ones too. So your goal is to make it wide, so you have a lot of pumpkin stems that have 2 sides to grow to. Last, I want to show you how you can expand your farm. Either you can make it very long, as you can see here, or you can tower it up, like here. Note that you have to add fences on each layer, so that all items land in the strip down below. Or to make it really space efficient, you can also make a big cube of it. As you can see, the fences from each cell are the border for 2 cells, so for really high space efficiency. I hope you enjoyed the video. Goodbye.